spine. Come on in. And for the love of God, close the door. Now be calm. I'm sure it's not as bad as you think. Are you hurt? Oh, you deserted. Well, I guess that is bad. Okay, let's not panic. We will think of something. After a good cup of coffee, I'm sure we will find a solution. But firstly, let me wash your face. You've been on the road for many days, and it's hot and dirty. And, well, you look like a grey ghost. Let me get you cleaned up. Clears your face, but it also clears your thought. Yeah, close your eyes. Just wash your eyelids. Your lashes. Sand. Dust on the road. Let me wash your lips. So dry. It's much better. Now wash your cheeks. I'll just wash your ears, okay? And we're done. Yes. Much better. Much better. That was an improvement. Now you look like a pale ghost. Well, I'm sure a good, strong cup of coffee will bring some colour into your cheeks. These I've just roasted in the pan. I bought them only 2 weeks ago from the peddler. They make a wonderful sound, don't they? The coffee mill is a little rusty for the want of use. Coffee is a rare commodity in these times of scarcity. But this is an emergency, for sure. A few lumps. Now, let's think about what we can do. No, don't apologize. Don't try to explain. I cannot imagine what it's like. But we all know what this war was doing to the soldiers, as well as the widows and the parents bereaved. And the children, fatherless. I know you. I know you're brave, and that you didn't want to desert your friends and comrades. But your mother already lost 2 children in the war. You're the only one she's got left. This war is fueled only by the folly and pride and misunderstood national feeling of rich men who don't have to fight themselves and who send their own children to study in Paris. What is that? The Bible. from your comrades. Your child is not a coward. He is just as brave as his siblings. He didn't want it to desert, but we all swore an oath to make him come back alive to save your last child. Tomorrow, we'll go into what might be our final battle. And perhaps only a few of us will return. We forced him to escape, or we would have wounded him ourselves to keep him from the battlefield. Please, don't judge him. Keep him safe, for he sacrificed what he held dearest. Not to bereave you of your only living child. In honor and loyalty, his friends from the 20th Regiment, 2nd Company. I understand, and your mother will. But not everyone will. And you're facing imprisonment and harsh punishment. If you're found. Tonight, we will hide you here. And tomorrow, I'll find a way to get you somewhere safe. Until all this is over. And I will get this letter to your mother. And she will be so proud of you. Just like your brothers would have been. Now, you must get some rest. And try not to worry about tomorrow. I will find a solution. I have many close friends who we can trust completely. They also know you and your mother and the fate of your brothers. They will gladly help you. Everything will be fine. Now I have a large basket of wool to cart, and the sound and the smell will remind you of home, and it will make it easier for you to relax and fall asleep. Please lie down on the bench. You need your strength for tomorrow. I cut the wool to make sure the fibres are entangled and aligned in one direction, making it easier to spin smoothly. Now this is wool that was trimmed off the sheets in the spring. It has been washed, but not too well, I'm afraid. Look at how my hands are tainted by the dirt and wool grease already. Well, firstly, I need to pull the locks apart and detangle the fibres to make it ready for carding. Normally, this would be a gentle exercise, but since this wool has been poorly cleaned, I have to work a little harder. The smell of the wool is that warm, homely scent of animal and cold but cozy windows. That's good. You just lie down and relax and try to fall asleep. Just listen to my voice and the sound blade is loosened, and I can separate the fibers more gently into a line from his cloth. I place the clumps of fleece onto the bottom card. With a swift motion, I draw the other card down into the bottom card. I have to be careful to put the right amount of pressure to the card so that the piece will grip the glue but not mesh the piece and the card together. And I'll continue this brushing motion until the wall is smooth and the fibers look like they're all going in the same direction. I will move the wall from one card to the other during this process. Watching how the wall gets fine and fine in structure as the fibers are detangled and aligned. Thank you. combed fleece is pulled off of the calf. And these little bundles are called rollouts, and then I'm ready to be dyed or spun. You're ready to sleep. You're safe tonight. And tomorrow we'll find a way out.